This is Goodison Park, where Everton have known so much glory down the years. League champions as recently as 1985 and 1987. But now, all connected with the club, are biting their nails. A win today is essential. Even that will not guarantee avoiding relegation for only the third time in the Merseyside club's 116-year history. Corner given. And they will miss the presence of Fashanu. Robbie Earle, one of three coming from the edge of the area, making their moves now. Oh, is that handball by Limpar? It was crazy, absolutely crazy. It's a penalty, and Limpar wonders what he's done and what the consequences might be. He was worried perhaps that the ball would go over his head, but there really could be no explanation for that. So the responsibility passes to Holdsworth here. And it just gets beyond Southall, who stays down in despair, really. He went the right way. Which way are Everton going? At the moment, you'd have to say down. Blackwell penalised. Now, here's a free kick for Everton. But it is teed up for Gary Ablett. Oh, it was hit hard and true. And the save had an air of nonchalance about it. But it's a push by David Unsworth, the 20-year-old. On Holdsworth, and a free kick is what it's worth. Oh, going for the same ball, Clark! And it's ended up in the back of the net, despite the valiant attempts of Gary Ablett. And it goes from bad to worse for Everton. They're 2-0 down. And the desire to please in the middle here had defenders going for the same ball. And then there was Clark. It may well have been going wide. And when you're down, well, dreadful things happen. And it's a dreadful afternoon so far for Everton Football Club. In the 21st minute, Andy Clark will claim it. Breaks for Limpar again. Oh, he's given the penalty. And as Limpar goes some way towards repaying a debt here. There wasn't too much contact from Peter Fear, but Limpar, the type of player to make the most of it, I must say, that does not look a very justifiable decision. But it's been given. This could just open up the possibilities again. A pressure penalty, if ever there was one. And Stewart is equal to the task. Everton 1, Wimbledon 2. Well, they've got a break. No sign of nerves. Holdsworth, oh. Well, he's let them off the hook there. The long throw, and 6 yards out, bang in front of goal. Holdsworth put his header over the top. Jones decides to go short. This is Gale. That's great play from him. Can he cut it back now? Oh, it flashed across, and it was too much for Holdsworth. That was not at all as straightforward as the header that he put over earlier in the half. But Marcus Gale mesmerising Everton here. Seeing what was on in the centre, but just putting too much power as he picked out Holdsworth. Everton survive. Cotty. Stewart. Still, he's got the way through! Can they finish it off? Well, first to it was Scales. Sager's had no protection there. Well, it was a great break. Setting the tone, Everton hope for the second half. But Sager's stopping it superbly from Graham Stewart. They can't get rid of the spectre of relegation yet. Oh, and Peter Fear, it drops for him. Just waiting and hoping that it would drop his way on the edge of the area, and he wasn't disappointed, and it wasn't a bad try at all. Jones with a cross. Oh, Southall's nowhere. Holdsworth. Dean Holdsworth. Went in at the far post there. Southall fumbled it. There was a fear from the Everton fans that the ball had gone in. Holdsworth was sure it was a corner. It was an unusual position that Southall found himself in as the cross came over. And a corner it is. From Elkins. That's Gale's flick. So, well-worked set piece that so nearly came off for Wimbledon. Peter Fear is now offside. This was the earlier incident, and it was Stewart, in fact, who saved it on the line. Well, what will that mean when they add it all up at the end of play here? This was what happened from the corner. Up there, Dave Watson, of course. It's Horn again. Can he do it a second time? Wimbledon defended it through the header from Jones, and then it bounced Barry Horn's way again. Stewart, Cotty. They've never exactly been in full cry, Everton, but they are in the ascendancy at the moment, and they'd love to be so on the scoreline. Limpar, oh, right out! Couldn't reach it. Had he done so, there was enough pace on the cross to suggest that any sort of header would have sent the ball speeding towards the Wimbledon goal. 9 minutes to go. Limpar goes inside this time. Stewart. Cotty came quickly to him. Stewart! Yes! Yes! For Everton! They can see salvation. Astonishing scenes of celebration here. And Graham Stewart, who has hardly set the club alight since his move from Chelsea, has really come good on the big, big day. That nerveless penalty in the first half, and now this low shot, almost side-footed, steered in beyond Segers. The attack seemed to have lost its momentum here when Limpar played it to Stewart, but he quickened it up. Cotty got a touch, and it was just a little prod from Stewart, and it found its target. Stewart. It's over. Everton have done all that they could do for themselves, and it looks as though it's enough. When a victory was critical, they've come up with it. But what a way to do it. Two down, a stupidly conceded penalty right at the start, an own goal by Gary Ablett when Andy Clark's shot was going wide and it muddled in off the Everton defender. One turning point, the Everton penalty, which Wimbledon certainly weren't pleased with the decision. And then in the second half, Barry Horn, with his first goal of the season, found a storming shot past Hans Segers. And then a goal-scoring effort of an entirely different variety, slid in by Stewart, who'd taken that penalty so well to give Everton hope. The consequences of failure, enormous. The pressure on the Everton players, enormous. But they rose to the challenge, and how.